What if when you woke up in the morning, instead of stressing out, sorting through all your clothes, trying to mix and match to put together an outfit that lights you up, you just opened up an app on your phone and explored your entire wardrobe without having to dig to the back of your closet to see your options? What if you could experiment and get creative with your outfits while tracking them on a monthly calendar to get real data on how often you wear your clothes, how worth your money each piece has been, and what the utilization is for your wardrobe as a whole? And what if I told you that you could do that? And that I did it first, and I recorded the whole thing, so that you can watch me do it before deciding if it's something you wanna try yourself. So what is digitizing your wardrobe? Honestly, it is exactly what it sounds like. It's inputting all of your clothes into an online database that allows you to sort through style outfits and track patterns in what you wear over the course of months, quarters, years, however long you intend on using this application. There's a few different digital wardrobe apps on the market. The one that I'm choosing to use is called Index. I've seen a few creators that I follow use Index, and I have really liked the content that I've seen them make as a result of using Index. Shout out to AlexisOnChina83 and Beep World. Seeing them use Index to digitally catalog their own wardrobes really inspired me and made me feel like this is something that could really be helpful for my brain. And the features of the app truly are endless, with not only the ability to track your daily outfits, but also to track the cost of each item, the cost per wear of each item over time, and exactly what percentage of your wardrobe is getting utilized on a monthly, quarterly, and yearly basis. So why do I wanna do this? Why do I wanna take on the task of transferring my entire physical wardrobe into a digital setup like I'm in Clueless?
I mean, I get up, I brush my teeth, and I pick out my school clothes.
Number one, the styling options are really endless. Being able to see every item in my closet all at once is just going to help me remember what I own and what my options are. And also it'll just be insanely helpful for getting more creative with my personal style without having to try on and rip off 100 items and mess up my whole room in the process. Now I can just do it right on my phone. Number two, I think the recent capsule wardrobe challenge that I did really illuminated to me how difficult it is for me to understand which pieces in my wardrobe actually are the most versatile and get the most use. When I did that capsule challenge, I really went for what I've seen other people do, what I've seen work for other people, and as we learned, it really wasn't what worked for me. And before I try a challenge like that again, I feel like I really need to pull some data on what the most versatile pieces in my wardrobe are, and lucky for me, this is something that I can very easily track through Index. Number three, it'll be incredibly helpful for identifying wardrobe gaps. In what categories would it be a good idea to invest in more long-term worthwhile pieces, and which categories do I have covered? And last but certainly not least, maybe the biggest appeal of doing this for me is the financial tracking that is possible with this. One of the major reasons why I want to do this is for the data. Particularly the data as it pertains to cost per wear. I've been investing more in my wardrobe over the past couple years, upgrading to higher quality, more worthwhile pieces. But I am curious if the money that I'm spending on each of these items is worth it based on how much I actually wear them. And if I find out that it's not worth it, how can I focus on styling those pieces more often in my wardrobe? So really, it's quite fitting that today's video is sponsored by Rocket Money. Because really, when you boil it down, my main goal with all of this is just to be more aware of my financial decisions as it pertains to my wardrobe. Rocket Money is a personal finance app that helps you cancel subscriptions, lower bills, and overall just manage your money better. I personally have been using Rocket Money to manage my finances for a little over a year now, and it works fantastically for my brain. In the past, I used to set budgets and track my finances in a Google spreadsheet that I managed, because honestly, a lot of finance tracking platforms just don't really click inside my brain. Nothing really gelled with me until I found Rocket Money. For one, Rocket Money is extremely helpful when it comes to canceling unwanted subscriptions. I find myself in possession of a new unwanted subscription at least once a month. How does this happen? I don't know. There's some new show that comes out on a streaming platform that I won't use otherwise, and then I just forget to cancel it. Rocket Money helps you safely and securely identify recurring charges and then cancel unwanted subscriptions for you. You can even cancel straight within the app without making any customer service calls. But I think the main appeal of Rocket Money to me is the budgeting capacity. Being able to set various budgets for every single category in my life and then track spending throughout the month in each of those various categories. Shopping, obviously, being one of them. Overall, Rocket Money has helped save its customers up to $740 a year when you use all of the features of the app, with over $500 million in canceled subscriptions. So to save more and spend less, join the over 5 million members using Rocket Money today. Just go to rocketmoney.com/MaddieDrosbaek or click the link in the description of this video to get started today completely for free. You can unlock even more features with Premium, but the Rocket Money app itself is completely free of charge. So again, that's rocketmoney.com/MaddieDrosbaek to get started completely for free, and thank you again to Rocket Money for sponsoring today's video. Now, without further ado, I do fear that it is time to start digitizing my closet.
I posted on my Instagram that I was gonna be doing this, and a ton of people messaged me a ton of advice about doing this in a seamless way, some of which I'm taking into consideration. Other bits I'm not, and maybe it will be a living and learning kind of thing. The number one piece of advice that people gave me was to do it over several days or weeks, to do like little chunks at a time. I love that you think I have enough self-control to not do it all at once. This is fun to me. Like, this is a beast and it's gonna be hard, but this is also like so much fun. I'm having so much fun. Once I get inspired and excited about something, I just need to like take that energy and run with it. So that's what I'm doing while I'm excited about this, while I'm having fun. I just wanna bang the whole thing out also. The reason why I wanna do it right now is because I'm switching over my closet from the warm months to the cold months. All of my excess clothes have been taken out from underneath my bed. So while I have everything that I own within arm's reach, I'm, you know, let's throw it in, let's document it now. Also, I made this like helper. This little spreadsheet that I can throw things into while I'm going through my closet, so that way I don't have to pause and drop everything in the app in the moment. Instead, I can just take a quick picture, log all the details in this chart, and then sit down afterwards and put all of them in at the same time. I feel like this will save at least a little bit of time, which is gonna be good because I am chasing daylight a little bit. It's 3:30, sunsets at like what, 7 o'clock these days? And I would like to get a lot done today. I would like to feel very accomplished by the end of today, moving into tomorrow. I also purposefully put on an outfit today that I already put into the app. So we're not serving looks, but everything on my body already been put inside. I am really liking the format of the app though. This is everything that I've put in so far. So as you can see, I have some clothing items in here, but most of it is shoes and accessories. But I had downloaded a digital clothing app before. I think it was Wearing, and I inputted some of my stuff, tried to make it look cute, but I think overall the like format of the app, the functionality of it, just didn't mesh well with my brain. And I think that's the hardest part about something like this. It's not even the logging, going back in your emails to find receipts, figuring out when you obtained certain items, how much they cost, so you can calculate the value of your wardrobe and then begin to calculate cost per wear for each of the items. That's really not the hard part. That's just like a task that needs to get done. Something you need to check off the list. The hard part to me is actually finding a platform that you gel with that is worth putting in all the time to load everything in. Like, if it doesn't work with your brain, then it's not worth putting all that time in, because if it doesn't work with your brain, like, then what's the fucking point? But Index is really, really working for my brain. But I've been saving all of the podcasts that I like, all of the episodes that came out this week, I saved them so that I could listen to them today and tomorrow. Ooh, I'm having such a good weekend. So I think I'm just gonna throw on a podcast, throw on a YouTube video, and get to going here.
So in order to log an item, the information I need to have is the brand, size, color, price, and date that I bought the item. I'm kicking this off just trying to be as focused as possible because I would really love to bang this out in one weekend. The cats are, of course, super interested in everything I'm doing, and although it is so cute, they're definitely setting my schedule back slack a bit by trying to nap on every item of clothing that I lay down to photograph.
I don't know if this setup is gonna work.
Girls, you need to sit anywhere else besides the clothes that I'm photographing.
Little girl, I know you wanna sit right on mommy's jackets, but we really can't do that, okay? You're in jail right now.
Jail, 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 jail.
You can play up here.
Mango, not you too. Oh my God.
You also wanna check it out? It's gonna be a long afternoon.
I don't know if it's just a sudden urge of passion that's motivating me right now or what, but I feel so eager to get this done so I can really reap the benefits of having a totally digital wardrobe to sort through every morning. It's tough that of all the weekends I've decided to have this surge of inspiration, it's the one where it's dark as hell all day long, just rainy and cloudy, and for an apartment that doesn't usually get a ton of natural light as it is, today is just about as shitty as it gets, which is posing some problems with taking photos. So, something I've been doing to troubleshoot, and also just because it looks cleaner in general, is Googling the items I'm logging to see if I can find any professional flat lay images that the brand took floating around online. If it's a recent item, I've been able to find it super easily, but even with some older items dating as far back as 2018, I've been able to find some nice images online floating around somewhere or attached to the email receipt that I was sent when I purchased the item. It's a nice little hack because I think, at least for me, I'm very visual, and if this is going to be a tool I'm going to use often, it definitely has to look nice. So making sure I have the best quality images possible is just going to help me stick to this and actually track my wares over a substantial amount of time.
All right, first 20 items down, it just so happened that everything on that rack came out to 20 items. That took me an hour. The long part is definitely searching for the receipts in my emails so I can see the price and what day I purchased each item. So that's 20 items down. I think next I'm gonna try to tackle what is in the underneath my bed bins. I actually just jumped right into logging the rest of my accessories and bags. So all of my accessories logged, all of my shoes logged, all of my bags logged. Now it is just clothes. So I think tomorrow I'm gonna have to start with the under the bed stuff, and then I'm gonna move on to my closet and dresser. I just feel like I can't go any farther because it is getting so dark in here.
It's only 5:45 right now, but as you guys can see, it is very rainy and cloudy and gross out today.
So if the weather was nicer, I would probably have another hour to keep doing this, but I'm already noticing the quality of my photos go down because of the lighting conditions. So I feel like I'm being forced to stop, which I'm not happy about, because I'm having so much fun. So I guess I'm just gonna copy all of what's in my sheet into the app. But let me show you the process of logging one of these items. All right, so this is my like home closet within the app. I'm gonna go to add a new item, choose photo. I airdropped some of the online images that I had. So let's log this Sandy Liang Bagu bag collaboration. The app will automatically remove the background from any photo that you put in, but obviously this photo that I just dropped in didn't have a background. Brand is Bagu, size non-applicable. This is red, category bag, top handle. Then once you have it imported in, I go into the item and edit some of the details about it. So I got this bag for Christmas last year. So 12/25/2023. I paid nothing for this since it was a gift, but the original price of this item, $62. Secondhand, no purchase location. I just write that it was gifted. Times worn, I've just been sort of guessing, because I do want to put some number in there because a lot of these items I've had for years and I know that I've worn 100 billion times. I don't think I've worn this purse that much. I want to say that to memory, maybe like 6 times. So that's the cost per wear section. Then I head over to the product info, name, what is it called, the Sandy Liang bow bag, tags. This is like, I don't know, I can kind of see this bag being cutie for any season. So all seasons tagged.
I know it seems like a lot and it seems super daunting, but it honestly is fun. I'm having a good time. If any of my friends want to do this, you let me know. You invite me over. We'll have a bottle of wine and we'll sit and chit chat while we do this. It would be so much fun. I would have so much fun doing this. I just love organizing things. Honestly, it is very exciting to me. So I'm gonna transfer in everything that I logged today, and then I guess we'll just be back for day two.
Day two of cataloging my wardrobe, and I am distracted. To be fair, I made these plans before I began this undertaking, but I'm telling myself it'll be a nice little break in my day, which will help me focus more. Big picture. I'm meeting my friend Kendall at a coffee shop this morning to catch up and hang out before heading over to a sample sale happening at this jewelry store that I'm super interested in, Aerie Covert. I've never bought anything from them before, but they have the cutest, quirkiest little charm necklaces, bracelets, and bags that I've been dying to find a spot for in my wardrobe. And lucky for me, they're doing a sample sale today, so everything is majorly discounted, so I'm taking my opportunity.
I've never been more excited to try on a piece of jewelry in my life. Do you see this? I am very excited about it. Yeah? She acts like she wants to be held, and then I hold her and she's like, no, please God, no. See, watch this. Bye. Bye. I've had my eye on the charm necklaces and bracelets from Aerie Covert for forever, but they're so expensive that I like just could not convince myself to spend that much on a charm necklace, charm bracelet. So I never have. And then I saw they were doing their sample sale today where things are 50 to 80% off, which is huge for me because I want to have like a loaded charm necklace and bracelet. I'm not someone that could just feel satisfied with one charm or, you know, a handful. I wanted like 11 charms. So this was the best time ever for me to get these jewelry pieces. So I went with like a red charm theme for my necklace, some warm tones, an iPod, a martini glass, cherries, poppers. For my bracelet, I went with some cool toned charms, Dear Diary, a little Tamagotchi moment, Metro card, Brat. I'm so excited. You know, I really should have taken flat light images of the jewelry before putting it on, because that took forever and I lost a nail in the process. So, my goal is to take as many photos as humanly possible of my wardrobe before the sun starts setting, which again is probably gonna be early today because it is gloomy and dark as hell outside already. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm basically just going to hit the ground running, taking photos of everything that I possibly can. And then I'm gonna work backwards in finding like the receipts, the cost, all of that after the fact, and just get the photos first. Cause that's the part that is dependent on the lighting.
It is crazy how many items you can have stored away in such a tiny apartment. If you asked me at the start of this how many items I thought I had in my wardrobe, I would have told you like maybe 200 maximum, and that's including accessories, shoes, bags. But at this point, we're like 140 items in, and I haven't even touched my closet or drawers yet, so clearly I do not have a good gauge of how much I own. It's probably some out of sight, out of mind thing with apartment living, since you just have to shove items wherever they'll fit, which is honestly a major reason why I want to catalog my wardrobe in the first place. I want to remember everything I own. I want to see it all in front of my face so I can actually remember to get enough wear out of each of these items and really track when it might be time to let an item go. I feel like a lot of clothes in my closet I would be wearing more if only I could remember that I owned it. And I try to live by the rule of like, if the season the item is most ideal for passes and I go a full calendar year without wearing something, it might be time to consider donating, selling, and moving on from that item. But sometimes the only reason why I didn't wear it is because I didn't remember that I had it. And I know I'm thinking in advance here, but I'm really excited to be able to track how many items I part with over the course of a year and see the difference between items in and items out of my wardrobe.
I did as much as I humanly could, but yet again, it got dark outside. It's Sunday, September 29th right now. I really would love to finish this before October 1st so that I can start top of the month documenting all my outfits and just having it all loaded in there. I know that it might be ambitious because I can't emphasize to you how little I got through today. And I didn't even get into my dresser. I did my underbed and like 1/8 of my closet. I probably have like at least 200 more items to log, which is crazy. Did not realize I had this much stuff. Like how? This apartment's fucking small. Where's all this stuff fucking hiding? Also impressed with some of the durations I've had a lot of my clothes. Obviously, I think the majority of my stuff is from the last like 3 years, which makes sense because I think I went up a size around the beginning of the pandemic. And also I just feel like my style evolution really hit me once the pandemic was in full swing and I had so much time to myself to sit and think and, you know, decide what I wanted my style to be like. So it makes sense to me that most of my clothes would have entered my closet post 2020. But I have some pieces in my closet from high school. Urban Outfitters skirt that's still in my closet that I wore a few times this summer. And I fucking love it. Got that shit like my junior year of high school. I think it's like a medium too. Which that's also the interesting part of putting all of this in is seeing like the range of sizes in my closet. It's like I have clothes that range from a medium to a 3X. Most of my stuff is 1X, 2X, 16, 18, but the sheer range of sizes in this closet is unbelievable. It's like just reminding me how inconsistent and unbelievable women clothing is when it comes to size consistency. I think I'm interested once my whole closet is put into the app to see what stores I actually have the most amount of clothes from. My guess is that it's probably Ray or Anthropology, but who knows? I might be proven wrong. All right, well, that's a wrap on day two. Hopefully day three is our last day.
Yesterday, I did up to here. You can't even see it. Everything behind me, I haven't touched yet. The only things I have logged are in this far corner of the closet. So literally all of this, I still have to go through and log. I don't understand how I've already logged like 167 items or something. I don't know where it's coming from. I don't know how there's still more. My goal for today is to finish this. I think I'm gonna try to bang through this closet, just head down, get through it as quickly as possible. I'll take a break, I'll log the whole closet, and then I'll do my dressers. The dresser should take a much smaller amount of time because one, two of the six drawers are undergarments, which I'm not logging. And some of the items in the dresser, I probably won't log at all. I'm logging loungewear, but I'm not gonna log like pajamas. I think that's what I've decided on. Obviously I do sleep in loungewear, but I would also like wear loungewear for an entire day and like chill around the house. I would go do my laundry in loungewear. I would go run an errand, go pick up my matcha. Like, if I would feel comfortable wearing an item in front of other living, breathing human beings outside of people that I am quite intimate with, then I'm gonna log it. If it's something that exclusively is on my body when I am under the covers in bed, mostly because it's not gonna be helpful for me to have that in there just taking up space, because it's never gonna get logged in my journal, and then I think it would fuck up like the usage percentages of my wardrobe, because there's a percentage of my wardrobe that is never gonna get logged even though it is in use. So it would say I was using less than I was. It just feels like it would mess up the data to have stuff that I strictly wear in bed that I wouldn't wear in front of other people logged. So I'm not gonna do that. And a lot of what's in my dresser is that. So I think that part will go faster. It's all this is gonna take a lot of work. I'm starting this at 9 a.m., okay? So we are cracking in, and hopefully I'm giving myself enough time to finish this today. Today's matcha, courtesy of Lazy Susie and Bushwick. This is also a very good matcha. Definitely behind Sips, but maybe tied with Swallow. Cheers, let's get into it.
Third day cataloging and hopefully our last. This has actually been super relaxing, just listening to a bunch of podcasts, indulging in whatever hour-long commentary video is in my YouTube recommended, and going through the motions of logging. I like having tasks to complete. It's why I love games like Toontown, because I have a very clear objective, and it's not like impossible. It just takes a while. I know that was a weird comparison to make. I do love tube down though. It's difficult in terms of effort, but not necessarily in skill. Though it does take skill, and having skill makes the end result better. But you can be shitty at it. Is this analogy working for anyone else, or is this too niche? Anyways, now that I'm starting to see a fully formed wardrobe come to life on the app, I'm starting to really look forward to being able to use the collections feature in the app, where you can make tiny little capsule wardrobes, which is one, going to be huge for travel, and two, gonna be huge whenever I try to do that capsule challenge again. Being able to plan all my outfits out on a calendar and connect them to a collection is just an absolute game changer, and it's gonna help so much to plan outfits with overlapping pieces and be the most strategic with what fills up my tiny suitcase. I'm heading to a wedding next weekend, and I can already tell my suitcase is probably gonna be the lightest it's ever been. No need to overpack when you have everything planned out and cross-checked. I've literally been yapping about this app to anyone that will listen at this point, begging all of my friends to get on it and catalog their wardrobes, because then we can style each other. Like, how fun would that be? Everyone go tell Kendall to get her wardrobe cataloged, and we can do a little style swap video together where Kendall styles my clothes for me and I style hers for her. It could be huge, you guys. Huge.
You guys, I finally did it. And you know what? I did it by October 1st, so you can suck a fat one to all my haters and doubters. Well, actually, to be honest, I finished it on October 1st. Today is October 1st. But it's done, it's finished, it's completed, which means today I get to log my very first outfit in the Index app. So I had to make it a good one. Let's do a little OOTD, shall we? I just unboxed these pants this morning. They're from Anthropologie. They are so flowy, so loose, so comfortable. It is very much giving pajama pant with boxers peeking out underneath, and I love it. On top, I have this white button-up shirt from Ray, which I will thank Index for being the reason why I'm wearing their shirt today. To be honest with you, I don't think I've worn this shirt in 2 years. I forgot that I owned it. Honestly, I wouldn't have thought to put this on this morning if I didn't open up my Index app and search for various tops that could pair with these pants. Threw on my purple and white cardigan from And Other Stories on top. Pulled out this bag to pair with it. I am about to head out to the movies. Which, is this not the most perfect movie outfit? The satisfaction that I got logging this outfit in the app, seeing the photo of the outfit sit itself right on my calendar, both the item image and the selfie of me in the mirror. Ah, it's so good. It's so good. Which, thank God, that's the truth, because I just spent 18 hours over the last 4 days doing this. So you would hope that I was a fan following that amount of effort. But my God, I am such a fan. I am so excited to get into the data here. You have no idea. Just soak it up, get a little nerdy with it. In total, there are 321 items in my closet. Of those 321 items, the highest category percentage is tops, coming in at 35% with 111 items. It is pretty much double the size of the category that is second to it. So I have a lot of tops. A good chunk of those are t-shirts. I feel like you just accumulate t-shirts over the years, but you know what? I can't even say that they're that significant of a percentage. I really do just own way too many tops. My second highest category is bottoms, coming in at 19% with 61 different bottoms. The third highest category, and this one was at least a little bit shocking to me, was accessories, coming in at 13% with 41 items. That said, the more I thought about it, the more I was like, I think the majority of that category is sunglasses. So then we've got a lot of ties going on here. We've got 19 pieces in outerwear, one piece and other, which to me was activewear. So I put all of my like sports bras, bike shorts, things like that in the other category, because like, yes, they're tops and bottoms, but not really, because I'm not gonna style them in outfits. It's just active wear. And then I have 18 bags. So all of those categories were coming in at 6% of my wardrobe. And the lowest percentages are shoes, jewelry, and swim. I knew that shoes were gonna be at the bottom. And I also know that the cost per wear on my shoes is gonna be ass, because I only wear my fucking Nikes. Jewelry, I only have 8 pieces of jewelry logged. I logged my necklaces and my earrings. I didn't do my rings or my bracelets because I don't take them off. So it felt like it would be crazy to have to log them every single day. And then it would mess up all my data, because I'm gonna have like 3,000 wears on this ring. So it's gonna be at the top of all my data sheets, even though it's like, yeah, I wear it every day. I don't take it off. So jewelry's at the bottom there, but strictly because I'm not someone that switches up my jewelry. I do wear the same jewelry every single day. And honestly, I wear the same necklaces and earrings every single day. I just wanted like a little something to put in my outfit photos when I'm planning them, because I need to see the jewelry to be inspired, but I will wear the same jewelry every single day. And obviously the lowest category is swim. I live in New York City. I swim a few times of the year when I'm on vacation, so no need for lots of swimsuits. The color breakdown of my wardrobe was pretty predictable. The highest two colors in my wardrobe were black and white, 19% black, 12% white, and the next two highest colors are blue and purple, coming in at 11 and 10%. This color breakdown makes sense to me. I am usually wearing cool tones more than I'm wearing warm tones, and yellow is my least favorite color. To me, yellow is just a shittier orange. So 2% of my wardrobe is yellow. New versus secondhand. 95% of my wardrobe has been purchased new and 5% of it is secondhand. This isn't shocking to me. I know that the majority of my wardrobe I buy new. It's pretty hard to thrift when you're plus size, particularly in New York City. So I have a few pieces that I've thrifted over the years, but for the most part, my closet is bought new. Seasonal breakdown was interesting. It's pretty much an even split between all of the seasons. Spring coming out a little bit ahead of the other seasons, but overall pretty even split. And winter being the smallest percentage does make sense to me. I love being cold. I love the winter. So what that means is that I always dress like it's warmer in the winter because I like being cold. So I don't really own a winter coat. It's gonna sound crazy to some people because I live in New York and I don't own a winter coat, but I don't own a winter coat. You'll catch me in my leather jacket in the middle of winter and that is fine to me. I own one coat total and it doesn't have a button on it. It's just like a fashion, fluffy blue coat, this one. So that's kind of like a winter coat, but the not having a row of buttons thing, just having like a little latch in the front. It's more of a fashion coat. Longevity, this is interesting. 3% of my wardrobe I obtained over 5 years ago. 8% I obtained 3 to 5 years ago. 60% of my wardrobe was obtained 1 to 2 years ago. And 29% of my wardrobe was obtained within the last year. This makes sense to me for a few reasons. Number one being that I went up a size shortly after the start of the pandemic. And this was around the time that I started working for myself, making significantly more money than I had in the past. Therefore, I had more money to invest in higher quality pieces. So it really was around 3 years ago now that I started to have a kind of style transformation, investing in pieces that were the proper size and also that were higher quality than the things that filled my wardrobe previously. But that said, I still do own a bunch of pieces from before that. It was so interesting going through my wardrobe and actually logging the dates that I acquired each of these pieces. Now, obviously I don't have a lot of data on the usage of clothes in my wardrobe since I'm just starting tracking that now. And when I was logging each of the items, I was putting in an estimate of how many times I've worn each item. But to be honest, I was for sure on the conservative side with my estimates, because I didn't want to estimate that I had worn something 100 times and be like, that's way too many. But like this black purse, for example, that I pretty much use every single day. This is my most worn purse. I probably have used this well over 100 times. I've had it for 3 years and I use it almost every single day. Like, the number's gotta be up there. I have no idea what that number is. I just know that I use this all the time. So it's gonna be interesting to loop back around in like 6 months' time to see, like, okay, looking at the last 6 months, how many days have I used this bag? How many times have I worn these items? What percentage of my closet gets utilized in a 6 month time span? And like, which items are the ones that are really truly my favorites. Now, using the estimates that I put into the app, it says my average cost per wear across my entire wardrobe is $21 per item, which sounds pretty fucking terrible. But again, I don't know how accurate that is. I was just putting in some numbers to give us a starting point, but I would love to see that number go down in the next 6 months. I can also see the total value of my wardrobe and how much I have spent on each category. I'm not gonna show you guys what the final cash dollar amount is, but I'll show you the spend percentages per category, just because I feel like it's probably not a good idea to tell someone the exact value of a ton of items in my home. You know? But these are their percentages. 27% of the money that I have spent on clothes has gone to tops, 22 to bottoms, 12 to one pieces, 10 to outerwear, 8 to accessories, 7 to shoes, 4 to activewear, 4 to bags, 3 to swims, and 3 to jewelry. And the number one thing that I was curious about is, what is the brand that actually takes up the majority of my wardrobe? I had a feeling that it was either gonna be Anthropologie or Ray. I know that these are the two stores that I shop at the most, but I had no idea which one was gonna take the final crown. And it turns out that it is Anthropologie. The majority of my wardrobe is from Anthropologie. I own 29 items from Anthro and 21 from Ray. I'm on day 2 of having everything logged into this app, and I'm already experiencing the joy, the ease that comes with having your entire wardrobe digitally cataloged. The skirt that I'm wearing right now, this one right here, I bought this skirt from Ray earlier this summer and thought that I would get so much wear out of it. I then didn't wear it even once because I couldn't figure out how to style it. I have had this app figured out for the last 48 hours and I've already figured out a way to style this outfit, to style this skirt. I feel like it just opened a door, it unlocked something creatively to see everything laid out like this. So now I am committing myself to using this every single day. I'm gonna track everything I wear over the next 6 months. I'm gonna track what leaves my wardrobe, what enters my wardrobe, how the cost per wear changes, what percentage of my wardrobe I actually utilize over a 6 month time span, and I will come back to you guys and update you on my findings 6 months from now. April, you'll see me right here and we will go through everything that I have learned after 6 months of using this app. My goal would be to get the cost per wear down overall in my wardrobe. I'd love to see that drop a couple dollars. I wanna be getting more usage out of my entire wardrobe. I wanna make sure that if I am bringing new pieces into my wardrobe that they feel really worthwhile. And I just wanna see how tracking my wardrobe in this way can help me be a more mindful fashion consumer moving forward. Honestly, this was a lot of fun for me to do. It was a lot of work, don't get me wrong, but if you're interested in fashion in any way, if you love styling things and getting creative with what you wear, or just wanna be a more mindful consumer when it comes to your wardrobe in general, I think this is a worthwhile use of your time. It is definitely an investment of time. No one said that it was easy or quick. It is definitely not. But honestly, if you're a fashion lover, I highly recommend doing something like this with your own wardrobe. But that's it for today's video. That is all the data that I have to share with you guys. I'm excited to loop back around in 6 months and see where things are sitting, but I'll definitely be posting more about my experience with the app moving forward over on my Instagram at Maddie Dragsbaek. So be sure to go follow me on there to see all of my updates. And if you're missing me in the interim, I do have a podcast, Emotionally Online, that goes live every single Friday. Last week I cried for like 40 minutes about being scared about getting older and seeing everybody you love start families of their own that don't include you. So you know, we have fun over there. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for hanging out. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.